just wrote a song in my car, and I recorded it in my car, and it will become a song on an album. I am the most prolific songwriter in the history of mankind. I don't know what else I've accomplished, but I can always hang my hat on that. I feel good about that. You're listening to Drive Time. It's March 28th. It's Thursday. It's 12:59 Eastern Standard Time, New Jersey. It's warming up quite nicely. We've got to be 50 degrees today. As we get closer to April. It's nice. Feels great. I'm going to walk my dog. I'm going to do some art music projects when I get home. I'm going to continue to do this thing called life. That's what it's called. There was a dead raccoon right by my office entry driveway. And the raccoon was pretty much smashed into just like a pink spot on the pavement. Like a pink grayish red spot on the pavement. I'm not sure if that guy was coming out or not. One day, if I keep doing this long enough, what is that law? We'll go back to the roadkill story in a second, but what is that law where you keep doing it over again? So, that just a law of averages? I feel like there's a... What's Godwin's law? There's nothing like that, is it? I can't think of God... I know what Godwin's law is, but I can't... It's not this at all, I don't think. If one day I will get hit by a car on camera if I do this every day, I think. No, that's not necessarily true. I could never get in their car accident the rest of my life. I feel like I probably will get into some sort of small accident. I've been in relatively few bang-ups. Probably two or three in my life. Nothing serious. I should wear my seatbelt, though. So that's one thing. I'll definitely... Wow, people are catch me an illegal left-hand turn. And he was looking kind of hard. He was a hard-looking man. Like, I'm in like five different zones at once here. So I'm going to get back to the roadkill story. I feel like I just entered like five planes of reality and then came back around. I really feel weird right now. Like, I saw this guy in a car, and I concentrated on his head for a second, and forgot I was doing this completely, and it was almost like I was that guy. Like, I was in his head. It was amazing. But I was talking about Roko. I'm back now. I'm back in full force here, I think. With my story about the roadkill, about the pink, gray, pink, black blotch of former raccoon on the pavement. It was disgusting. It was like he was newly dead one day, and then in the course of four or five days, he was almost part of the road because he'd been run over again so many times and squished. And then just this morning, there's, I think it's like another raccoon, but it's like brown almost. I don't know what animal it could be. It's almost like maybe a woodchuck. Or groundhog. I haven't really examined it. Because at first I was like, there's the thing. But then I was like, wait a second, that can't be the same animal. That was, that animal had been flattened. And this was more, it had animal quality still. So basically, two animals died in like almost the exact same spot within the course of a week. They're doing construction up here, so this is taking me a lot longer to get home, so this might be a little longer episode. I'm gonna roll with it. The good thing about being a talk show host, when you've got 20 episodes under your belt, as I do, you get good. You get good at handling, adversarial situations. My heat is on my car, my god, that's why I'm put my shades on. My eyes feel like it's sunny. What? My eyes feel like it's sunny. My eyes feel like it's sunny. Oh shit, there's this guy who's been putting up signs around here. I ran past a couple of them. I took a video that won't upload to fucking Flickr. And it plays fine on my computer. And I actually changed the file format like twice. And I can't get it to upload. It's like a vlog. I'm calling this thing these vlogs that I do. I'm trying to do 1,000 short little videos that are just like slice of life. But there's these signs and they say stump grinding. There's a number. Stump grinding. Stump grinding. I'm not, and I think, like, I don't even know what does that mean. Like, stump. Stump. A tree stump? They flatten it out so it's like, I guess what it means is I just figured it out in my head. With all the downed trees and the bad weather we had maybe since the fall and through winter, and now people are trying to, you know, get ready for spring and their lawns and manicure their lawns how they like, you know. Maybe stump grinding is you take, they're just, maybe that, does that just mean tree cleanup though? I mean, why would stump grinding be the way to describe that? So somebody is putting up these like handmade signs on yellow poster board that say stump grinding. Stump grinding. Which if all that means is taking away the dead tree and then maybe like sawing off the base so it's a tree stump, which makes sense. I just never would have imagined that to market that service, stump grinding would be the way to do that. I would just say tree removal. That makes more sense. I'm not like bugging. I'm not like making people. I guess maybe because I'm talking about it, it worked. But I mean, I'm not the target audience. So, I mean, good luck to the guy. It's obviously the same guy because it's the same handwriting. Sure, the same number on all of these signs. They're yellow posted, and like you must have put up, and all over too. Because I was in a totally different part of town. Not that the town, man. When you run, when you get into like long distance running, a town can just really seem small. Because I never considered this a small town by any means. You know, obviously when you say small town, you're not really. Square mileage is not the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the phrase small town. Small town is, you know, an idea. Small town could probably, if anything, it means shit's further away from each other because it's, you know, kind of a lazy small town. So maybe, like, it's expansive mileage-wise, square mileage-wise, but it's just not a lot going on. But I never thought of my town as a small town in the sense that it was small. In either of those capacities, it's a moderate-sized town in terms of, what is the opposite of, like, small town? So, like, it's a, not a city, but it's, like, kind of a, not a, you know, a hub going on. It's an entertainment hub. But, you know, there's things to do where I live. So it's not a small town in that regard, and I never thought it was that small, although it is seemingly compact. It never seemed quite small, that small. But I'm like almost bored of like where to run, which is insane that could happen. That there isn't, you know, in a place this size, that there isn't just like I couldn't. It seems like I can't, even if I wanted to run 6 to 8 miles every day, I would be retracing my footsteps every third day. Does that make sense? Which, yeah, it's fine. Yeah. Every once in a while, it seems like the drivers just get a little crazy. It's always on the same day. Was it the weather? People got Easter fever? What's going on? Like 8 people tried to run me off the road just now. Run me off the road! But I won't have it, any of it. No, not me.